So at the end of last year, I then get back in contact with this guy. He says, no, it's not good enough. And I went, what do you mean it's not good enough? Can you give me some feedback? Can you give me some, I'm just stabbing in the dark here. Feedback is only good if it actually then tells you how to correct. Just getting bad feedback, which just says, well, it's crap, is not good for the ego, for a start. But it's also not good for, how do I improve this? So he said, read these two books, one of them which I'd already read, but I reread it from the perspective of, okay, he wants me to read it from an author's perspective, not a person that's digesting the information's perspective. And another one of them was written by a guy who was a hostage negotiator for the FBI for, about, 2015 years or something like that. And all of these stories are really, really exciting about their hostage negotiations. Well, I haven't got any hostage negotiations stories. And so, I'll just have a look at some of the little things that, the two people have done. And so I grabbed a few ideas from them and put them together and then resubmitted to him. And then he said, okay, well, I'll run it past one of my editors, and so he did. And she came back with, and this is what I had a crisis of confidence, and I then got in touch with Jane, and I'll tell you about that in a second. She came back and she said, reads like it's a how-to manual, and even the stories in it fall a bit flat or something like that. And I went, well, okay, at least there's actually some substance to go by on what they're talking about. But then I thought, well, it is a how-to manual. It is to be able to engage people to say, well, here are some tools that you can use. And then there are 15 vignettes about various people who have problems that I've either worked with in corporate life or in clinical life. And so I'm sort of, giving all of these things, and I'm thinking, well, okay, obviously what she's meaning is it's a bit too complex. My wordage of this isn't good. And so I spoke to Jane, it was on a weekend, and I said, Jane, can you help? This is my tone in my text, by the way. Can you give me some feedback on this? What do you think? And so I'm driving around in this cul-de-sac because I had the phone to my head, but I didn't want to obviously be out in the open road. But it was really, really hot day, and so I had the air conditioning. And so we chatted for about half an hour or so, and then when I got back home, I flicked over to the three introductory. Three introductory vignettes, and she said, well, these read okay to me. I don't know what her story is. And that is the thing you've got to be careful of when people criticise your work, is that it's their perspective. And even if they're a professional in the game, it's still their perspective. J.K. Rowling, or however you'd like to pronounce it, was rejected 15 times before whoever took them up. The Beatles were rejected many, many times by Decca.
Yeah.
They got, and they introduced the Rolling Stones to Decca, they got shunned by them themselves. So, and probably lucky for the fact that they did, because, then they met George Martin, for anyone. This is probably too old for you guys, but they got shunned by all of these other labels, and then they met up with George Martin, who was the fifth Beatle, and if not for him and the catalyst that he brought into it, they probably never would have got what they ended up getting. So it ended up being a really good thing, and in the end, it's ended up being a good thing for me, because I'm in total control of this now.
Yeah.